This spell is for Robert Kay, someone who I believe answers whenever anyone calls my father's name, though he is not my father. He's some guy with the same name. The word is puss. It is spelled
P-U-S-S.
Puss!
Truth be told, at first I got excited because I thought the word was pus, and pretty much all my favorite people have spent at least a little while making some pus. But no, that's with one S like bus or plus, not two S's like cuss or fuss. This has nothing to do with pus or pussy, which is spelled this way, because that makes sense. This is puss, and not to be a sour puss, with all respect to octopus and platypus, nothing really rhymes with puss. The closest you can get are some slant rhymes like push and bush, mush, cush, and tush, but puss stands alone. It traveled like the folktale Puss in Boots from the Germans to the Brits, meaning cat. And they must have thought that their furry pets had something in common with flirty women because it picked up that meaning next. Meanwhile, next door in the Irish, it meant something to do with a purse or a bag. Like this. See the lips? That's what puss meant. Lips. And it came to English meaning the primary residence of the lips, the face. And then finally, at long last, the British and the Irish put away their ancient differences in joyous vulgarity to create a new meaning for the word puss that combined all the old senses. Now in America, it often ends with a Y, but you can make your meaning known without it, because puss stands alone.
Give me your words.
I spell them all.